Hello everyone! In this video, we're going to learn how to add third-party libraries into Cloudy and how to run model grids. Let's start by opening the Nublado website. We open the browser and we type the address. Here it is. And now, over here, we have the Stellar Atmospheres link. These are all the Stellar Atmospheres libraries which are currently supported by Cloudy. You have the instructions to install the Starbars 99 grids, the Atlas libraries, but in this particular case we're going to use the Popstar grids. This database represents a set of evolutionary synthesis models with a wide range of ages and metallicities. To start, we're going to download this script, which we will need to convert these tables into a format that Cloudy can recognize. We save it. And now we go to the Fractal website. And in here we go to the Downloads models. Okay, in this table you have all the models organized for different initial mass function and metallicities. From here you need to download all the spectra files for a given IMF. Myself, I will be using in this tutorial the Salpeter IMF files with the high mass limits, which I have already downloaded. I have them over here. And I have extracted all the files within the same folder. Okay, we open the terminal. We go to this folder. And the first thing we must do is to give execution rights to this Perl script. To do that, in Ubuntu, you type chmod plus x and the name of the file. Let's check it. Okay, it is green. That means in Ubuntu that it's an executable file. And now we need to run this command. Remember that you can name this file whatever you want. We press enter. It is done. Over here we have this popstar ASCII file. There is, however, still an additional step, as this cannot be recognized by Cloudy. To do that, we need to execute Cloudy. If you remember the location of the Cloudy executable, it is in the source folder. We press enter, and now you need to run this command. Compile, star, and the name of the ASCII file you just created. Remember, you must use quotation marks. We type enter once and twice. Okay, that was fast. And over here you have this mod file which can be read by Cloudy. Now you need to copy it and we're going to move it to the Cloudy data folder. Very nice. Now we can use it. Let's test it with this example I have over here. As you can see, we load the Popstar spectral energy distribution. Each stellar atmosphere database may have a different parameterization. For Popstar, we need to specify the age and the stellar metallicity. As we saw in the previous video, we need to define the incident radiation strength. In this case, we can look into Popstar evolutionary synthesis models. In this particular article, for young stellar formation bursts, we have the radius and the ionization factor for a grid of masses, edges, and gas metallicities. This allows us to easily calculate the number of ionization photons, which we have introduced here. You will appreciate that there are a few commands we have not yet seen. The first one is CMB. This command generates a black body radiation field, both shape and intensity, to include the cosmic microwave background. Over here we have a save line list command. This instruction is used to save the lines tabulated in this file, which are calculated from this model. It is important these line labels are in Cloudy format, but do not worry, Cloudy will tell you if it doesn't recognize them. We go back to the script. Also remember to read the command description in the HiSeq documentation, as you will find many tips to save the data in the format you want. For example, over here we just need the fluxes from the last iteration and without any hash marks in the text files. Finally, we have over here this very grid structure. This argument can be added to run several models which will modify the command magnitude. For example, over here we have 3 density values and 3 gas metallicities. Therefore, this script will run 9 simulations whose results will be saved on these files. Claudi provides several procedures to generate these scripts, including reading these ranges from the text file. Over here we have an initial, final, and step format, as well as the units. The original command value does not have an effect on the grid results, but it needs to be included anyway. Please refer to chapter 18 on HazyOne for all the options you have. Okay, let's run this script. We open a terminal. We go to this folder. And we run it. We wait a bit. Okay, it is done. We have over here the output files with the line flags predictions of the models. And as you can see, there are 9 sets of results from each of the models. Very nice. Okay, this is all I wanted to show you today. Thank you for watching and see you soon.